Today I am going to discuss about autonomic innervation of lacrimal gland. What is autonomic innervation and the pathway, afferent and efferent pathway of autonomic innervation of the lacrimal gland. Afferent pathway when stimulus arrived to the and when stimulus initiate to the specific part, then this pathway of stimulus is called afferent pathway. If this specific part show response, then the process of response of this specific part is called efferent pathway. Then, for example, in lacrimal gland, if a person is emotionally disturbed, it stimulate the hypothalamus. It stimulate the hypothalamus. This pathway from hypothalamus to the lacrimatory nucleus of facial nerve. This pathway is called efferent pathway. And the lacrimatory nucleus by different passage and provide to the by different passage lacrimatory nucleus of facial nerve show its motor function, secretomotor function. And if conjunctiva or cornea, is foreign body is present in conjunctiva and cornea, and trigeminal nerve is present, nerve endings of trigeminal is present on cornea, which stimulate the lacrimatory nucleus of the facial nerve. This is a sympathetic pathway of lacrimal gland, which is present on superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. And this is a parasympathetic pathway. Parasympathetic pathway consists of different passages to pass into the lacrimal gland to show secretomotor function. The fibers comes from lacrimatory nucleus, enter into the facial nerve. From facial nerve, it's a duct, the passage greater petrosal nerve, where it enter into the greater petrosal nerve and then enter into the nerve of pterygoid canal. After these fibers are called preganglionic fibers, because these ganglionic fibers are not synapse with the other ganglion. If these fibers, preganglionic fibers, synapse with the pterygobalantine ganglion, then it's formed the postganglionic fiber. This is postganglionic fibers, and this is preganglionic fibers.